Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So my name is Muhammad Akil Iman bin Ruzlan. So this is the final project for TPS 252, which is a geography information system. And then for the final project is about the real GIS application in commercial area, which is my commercial area is Dataran Austin. And then this assignment will prepare for my lecturer, and I would like to be thankful to my lecturer first, which is Miss Nur Shazlin binti Muhammad Rosli. Okay, so for the next slide, it's about the table of content. So I would like to explain a little bit about of my this assignment content. The first is introduction. It's explaining about the aim, introduction, scope of study, and then the second one is ER diagram. So I will explain it later. And then the site background, it's about the Dataran Austin, what kind of the commercial area of I'm choosing it. And then the GIS database, which is it's contain a special and attribute data registration process. What is the process of the GIS database to make a GIS database? And then the GIS outcome, so it's based on the three question: where does it locate, why does it happen. And then the last one is about the conclusion. It concludes all of this project to the one conclusion. Okay, for the 1.0, it is about the introduction. So this final project is about to required to construct a GIS database. And then okay, a factual GIS database, a real database from a case study. So the case study is at my home, the commercial area at my hometown, which is Dataran Austin. And conduct the relevant geospatial analysis in Map Info software. So Map Info is the one of the GIS software. There are many GIS software in our world. Map Info is one of I'm exploring it. And then like a systematic mapping and query analysis. So behind that, so they must choose a case study of commercial area with 10,000 square meter as a minimum size. It is can be captured through the Google Earth raster image or using the hybrid map that provide in Map Info software. Okay, we go through to the aim. So the aim of this final project is to construct a real database and geospatial analysis. Okay, so the objective, we have I have four objective, and then the scope of study is site. The first is site, which is the Dataran Austin. Of course, all of the data, all of the information is at there. And then the GIS Map Info is the main software that I'm using to make a geospatial, to make key in the attribute data. And then the analysis is the base on the three main question. This is the scope of study. And then we go through to the next slide, which is 2.0, which to designing an ER diagram. So what is this ER diagram? So ER diagram, or also known as an entity relationship, or we can be defined as a simulation of the real world. So before we go through to the to collecting data from the real site, we must to make a simulation. How to collect the data? What kind of the data we want to collect? So this is the ER diagram. After this, I will show you the ER diagram. So basically, ER diagram will divide to the three model, which is conceptual model, logical model, and the last one is physical model. Okay, so this is the conceptual model, and there is the logical model. From the logical model, it's relates with the physical model. So this is the method, the simulation, how it can be ER diagram. Okay, we go through the site background. So the first site background, The location is at Dataran Austin. The administration of the Dataran Austin is Majlis Mandiri Kuala Terengganu MBKT, and the mukim of the Dataran Austin is at Wakaf Tembesu. The district is Kuala Nerus, the new district in Terengganu, and then the state is of course Terengganu, and the site area is 1.56 hectare. And then this is three delineation of the boundary for the selected case study. This is three delineation lah. Okay. So this actually the process that I'm using the map info to map. This is the process lah. The registration process step by step. First, second, third, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So this is actually the process. Okay. So we go through to the DIS outcome. What does it? The first is the thematic map. So this is the building condition thematic map. And then the second to analyze is the commercial activity thematic map. And then the last one is the shop type, the commercial shop type thematic map. Okay. So from this explanation, we got the analysis of these three thematic map. And then where does it locate? So I'm having four area, the main area that can be a factors or justification distribution of Dataran Austin that make it more effective in Kuala Nerus. The first is residential area. We can see how big the residential area that surrounding to the my site, the Dataran Austin, and the school area is in front of the in front of the Dataran Austin, and then the supermarket. We so in 1.5 kilometer radius have two supermarket that will give the impact to the Dataran Austin. And then the recreation area, which is so Stadium Sultan Mizan Zainal Abidin lake area, can be the most primary attraction in not in Kuala Nerus but in Terengganu also. In Terengganu own will make the commercial area, the Dataran Austin is the most center commercial area in Kuala Nerus. Okay, so the last one for the analysis is about the why does it happen. So the first question, how many shop lot in status of vacant in level 2? So it's 25 units per 55 unit. It is because majority of the shop lot is the boutique shop, and the boutique shop is not necessary not have any activity lah in second floor. And then the question B is, how many shop lot in status of medium condition? It's only 3 unit. So this is because of Dataran Austin is only is a new development for the Kuala Nerus. So it is a modern commercial area lah. So we have Dataran Austin do not have any poor condition building. It only have a medium because of the sun age. Yes. And then the question C is about the boutique shop. Why 28 unit, which is near to the 50% of 55 units with boutique shop? It is because of commercial Dataran Austin is basically majority a local boutique, a local. So they want to take their opportunity to selling their own product to the local resident. Yes. And then the last one is conclusion. So this is the conclusion. This case study is located around the commercial area which is Terengganu Besut, and Terengganu approve new development town like Kuala Nerus. It is a new town to improve their commercial activities, so it can give a lot work of opportunity for people. Besides work opportunity, it can give also people easy to buy something that's really neat by not going to the near town, which is Kuala Terengganu. Which is in Kuala Terengganu lah. So that's all. Thank you.